Last time, we talked about the concept of sentience quotient and discussed a way to calculate different levels of sentience within our universe. We also talked about the possibility of different emergents that may occur at certain levels of intelligence or SQ values. If you haven't seen the previous video, it is highly recommended that you watch that first before watching this one. The link is in the description below. Today, we're going to be discussing the very first and the most primitive emergence of intelligence known as reactivity. So let's dive right into it. We know from last time that the dumbest possible brain in our universe would have an SQ value of negative 70, with a mass of the entire universe requiring a time equal to the age of the universe to process just one bit of information. In other words, this kind of brain, although sentient, does not have any real properties to be discussed, since it is extremely inefficient to talk about in any meaningful way. Now, since the intelligence level of these types of brains is extremely low, no new property is seen to emerge from them. So then, at what level of data processing does the first emergent of intelligence appear? According to this scheme, the most primitive emergent of intelligence is simple reactivity. It is the differentiation of body cells into specialized cells whose unique function is data processing. It may require a minimum of 10 to the 0 or 1 bit per second kilogram of data processing by the most primitive organisms to occur. In other words, any sentient being that possesses reactivity must be close to an SQ value of 0. If we relate this level of data processing and SQ level to something that our minds can readily comprehend, beings at the level of reactivity would be able to read about one word in 8,000 years, which is equivalent to reading one book in about 400 million years. So, what type of organisms are we talking about here? There are two basic types of sentience that possess the very first emergent property of intelligence: hormonal sentience, exhibited by plants, and genetic sentience, exhibited by most primitive organisms and the animal kingdom. Time-lapse photography shows the vicious struggles among vines in the tropical rainforest, along with vegetative phototaxis, which is just plants responding to and turning towards a light source. It is believed that these behaviors are mediated through biochemical plant hormones transmitted through the vascular system. Similar to the animal kingdom, carnivorous plants are the geniuses of hormonal sentience. For example, the Venus flytrap counts two stimuli during a 1 to 20 second interval before snapping shut on its insect prey. This requires the plant to process data at about 1 bit per second, and given its mass about 10 to 100 grams, it comes at an SQ of about plus 1. But plants in general take hours to respond to stimuli, therefore they tend to cluster around an SQ of about negative 2. Regardless, all plants exhibit reactivity at some level, giving them the first most basic emergent property of intelligence. Furthermore, primitive organisms like the amoeba is seen to respond to chemical gradients and bits of food floating by, indicating the emergence of reactivity as well. Colonies of ants, bees, and termites are all aware of their nest as one entity or living system, indicating a higher level of intelligence and SQ level, however, still lacking individual awareness. Similarly, all other animals cluster around the human SQ value, displaying a much higher intelligence level compared to vegetation and insects. But none of them are quite aware of themselves as individual beings, perhaps because they have not yet reached a data processing level that could give rise to the next emergent property of intelligence. So at what rate should a sentient being process data to be able to unlock the next emergent of intelligence? Well, that is a question for another time. Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Until then, we'll see you in the next one.